Okay, it's April 30th, last day of date of April, Saturday, 2016. It's 6:05 p.m. I just got through breaking the ground up one more time, made three little grooves, and I planted approximately 12 onion seeds in each of those grooves there, about 3 inches, two inches, 3 inches apart from north coming south. And watered them down. This is all loose here. I'm not really worried about this tomorrow. I'll maybe get this all up. But this will be the very last video on planting. We've got peppers to put out yet. And tomatoes, the second batch of tomatoes. But this is it for... Everything is planted now. We've got 12 ears of corn coming up. Plus I planted another 6 in the holes that were previously planted to see if we can't get, 12 total. Right now we have 6 total, 3 and 3. But I planted, like I say, 6 more total, so we'll have 12. And then next Saturday, we're going to go over one row and plant 6. And they're offset rows. You can see that one's closest to the border, and this one's about 12 inches into the garden. And they're already up. Okra, there's approximately 26 okra out here planted. We did a second planting again because of the wind and the rain out here. That's the only reason we've done this. But we have I'm not gonna zoom all in with the sun out here, it's too difficult. But right now there's about 4 okra. I can just see the one right by the detergent bottle, which these are all gonna get off the gardens here and by next weekend. But those are things that look like basically Christmas trees. They'll put out until October. Tomatoes in the first two rows, there's 6, 7. 7 of the 7, 6 of them look like they're gonna die. One of them looks like it might hang on. I don't know if you can see it. If I can zoom in, again with the sun, it's difficult to see where I'm looking at if I'm looking at the right one, but it's got some green leaves in it. Then we have 1, 2, 3 with this one here being small. This is the size I put out last year and it was so big. And so we got those hormones. I mean, this is what I brought in out from inside the house. This has been out for about a week now. We had coffee grounds around all these to help ward off the hornworms. But then in the this row here, we got 3 good sized ones. That one there, that one, it's hard, like I say, because it's so bright, it's hard to look on the screen and see that I'm looking at the right thing. And one there, and then the next row over there is 3 again. There's a spade. This one's for another. This more another tomato plant's going to go eventually, along with those other 5 in the first row. That's all looking like they're going to die. This one, I'm not sure about this one. That one there. So it'd be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, and maybe that's the 12 there. We won't use this one here, but we got that tomato plant there. That one there is so-so. See, that one was really good in the house. We buried it down. It was real green like this one. But the winds out here are what's really hurting everything out in the garden this year. I also started about 3 weeks earlier than I should have. Well, not really. It's, with the plastic, you can start 3 to 4 weeks early, actually, because it heats up the ground so fast and it'll make everything grow. But we're wide open. And as I have on previous videos, with all my swearing, you see the wind. That's why I tied this plastic stuff on this Odden tomato sticks. You can see the wind blowing out here, going around 8 to 10 miles an hour at least. And they say it's like 3 miles an hour, which is bull. But I got a bean down here. Don't know which one. This right here is a flora bean. There's 2 of them there. And I believe it's a bush bean. I'm not sure if it is or not. We're going to get another 50-foot roll of that fencing. And I put 2 flora beans down there today. Now, whatever bean that is on previous videos. You can look. There's one over here, too, next to the center block. And then I planted one there. I didn't like in triangles, threes. Three stations. Like here, I planted 2 right down there. Alright, focus on that. I want it to get clear. I can't really see it good, and I'm trying to hurry up and do this. And I did 1 or 2. I think I did 2 down here, too. And then right in that mound, that triangle there, the third point, there should be one or two in there. Here I did two. You can see one down there coming up. The leaf on one and one the other one without the leaf. And I have one over here. I thought maybe two. Could be two. See, even the cinder blocks are going to come off the plastic. And then I have two here. Now this one here is kind of a bit of a surprise. I'm wondering what this one is right here. I don't recall planting anything right here, but it is a plant of some sort. See, I'm the type of person, unless it's absolutely necessary, I'm not going to tear up anything. If it's a food of any type, I want it to grow, and I'll make way for it. We're going to buy, like I said, another 50-foot roll of this. I'll cut it in half and make it 100 feet by 18 inches, because we're going to have at least one, two, three, maybe four more rows. And plus, I might have to go further back here with these others. Now, going back toward the east, at the front of the garden is that where that floor of bean is. Then there's where I did another two in that short tomato stick. I planted beans. Let me go to the front and come back. It's easier to keep from being so mixed up like I have been. And I planted a tan bean right there. And I forget which bean here. That one should be Trail of Tears, Cherokee Trail of Tears. And that's a something with a T. I forget the name. It's on another video also. It's the white bean. Like, I got two down there, and I had just these leaves. I was gonna do these leaves, and I was gonna do string to the poles. And I thought, well, since this stuff wasn't too expensive, it was around $30 for a 50-foot row. I get a 50-foot row, 3 feet. And I was gonna use 3 feet, and I thought, I don't need 3 feet. And I thought, well, why not cut it in half? The only downside to that is one half is gonna have these little right here. Pointy things. I folded some of them up on the leads, and then and the other, you know, I see right here at the bottom they've got them, and then there's one set that won't have them. But that's two beans, the beans I was saying, Trail of Tears. See, now back here the same beans, nothing growing here, but then there's the Cherokee Trail of Tears, and there's that other bean which I don't know the name of, which you had to look on a previous video. The third bean that I planted when I did the four beans at one time. Let me go back up to the front here real quick. This was a big white lima bean type from a neighbor of ours that we gave seeds to last year. He planted and he brought his back. And the ones we had gotten were like the size of our regular beans that we usually get. The ones he brought me were almost a quarter size. I mean, they were big, and I planted them out here. Two of them are the marble, the reddish marble color swirl. And then the white ones. So that's what I planted there, and I planted down there. See, now again, nothing's coming out of here, but it's the same thing right there. This is the marble, the purplish marble one. There's two down there. No, one there, and one there. As you go back here, there's two and two. See, I got string to go through vine will start going out onto the string. That's why we need to get more fencing, like I said, because we have to attach going backwards. You know, we did this one here as about 6 foot attachment with a string in between, because we got two leads here and then the string going to that one over here in the very first three rows. First one, these are the first things I planted, was watermelon and then two cantaloupes. And only I just see the watermelon. You can, I don't know if you know, you can look on the viewfinder here. It's going to be hard to do this. There's a light green thing right next to that grass of blade. Let me take, see if I can get that. I'm breaking my neck. This is blade of grass. There. Blade of grass. There. You see that green thing right there? That's a watermelon. This one here and this one here. I think that's one of them, then that's cantaloupe. Then I went back halfway and did cantaloupe and watermelon. Again, I don't know if it's coming. Yeah, I think you can see the two leaves and watermelon. So the watermelon seems to be the only thing coming up right now. We've got more seeds. It's the last day of April right now, so next week is when we were going to plant anything else, because in the other gardens I've got cucumbers. I'll go to them now. So, with my sunflowers again, my sunflower fence to help block wind that we won't need no more in the summer. But in the spring, you saw previous videos, my cousin The wind out here is like the winds of hell. But look at how these are coming up now. And plus we have marigolds and some other flowers that are medicinal, you know, for medicine and such, around all, both these two borders, and then partially on that one over there by the tomatoes. Plus I have four peanut stations over there, four peanuts in each hole. So, previous videos, I jump around so much, I understand, but, see now, did I plant that? Yeah, I did. I put Super 8 cucumber down there and another cucumber with it, I believe. And then in that hole right there, too. So we planted one in there, one in that one, and one over there. And that one looks like it's coming up. That's why, yeah, there is, it looks like that's a cucumber coming up right there. Well, let me zoom back out and focus. Okay, that should be a cucumber. And then we planted down here, over there, and right there before. I planted down here and there. So one, two, three, four. One's growing, and I just planted fresh seeds there too. So we might have five or six cucumbers growing instead of just the three we were originally going to do. Because last year we did about 10 of them, and then we ended up planting another eight, and then they all blew up at one time. This is the traditional zucchini. It's called Black Beauty zucchini. It's the green that you see in the store. Last year we got the real big ones. I mean, I'm talking about the size of a person's arm. And they say to get them when they're small. And you can get them when they're small if you wish. That's fine. But I like them big. We got a few small, but we got them big most of the time. Because these heirloom seeds are the best you can get. I've got the golden zucchini right here. There's one there, and I planted another one there. There should have been one planted already, but I planted a second one, seed there for it. Again, that has to do with the soil. It has to be, because the seeds have always never failed. Here's another golden zucchini. There's a space there. I planted a second seed there. This is the only, well, it's not the only thing. Once in a great while, a seed may not grow. Everybody always plants two, and I think that's wasteful. But, you know, the thing is, that with that traditional green zucchini, that Black Beauty, we had so many last year, and we don't have any seeds. I have no idea what happened. But anyway, we'll do better this year. And that's another golden zucchini. Then I just planted a second pumpkin here. I planted a pumpkin seed in there about 3 weeks ago. I just planted a second one down there to see if it, well, you know, I wanted to get it growing. And then we'll try to guide it as it grows out of that hole. We'll try to get it to go as north as possible without going up onto the edge of there. Because like I say, we should have flowers coming up here in the next 3 weeks or so around the border of the garden. I did the onions over here, approximately 12, like I say, 12 to 13, 14 in each of those grooves there. We've got six garlic we planted on the last of October, early November. It should be the first of November, something like that. Then we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 garlic we planted, which again, everything's on video. When we take these six up here, what I'm going to try to do maybe is make two rows here. You know, look how these are. See, it's about 6 inches across here. Well, actually, no, it's about 18 inches across. So if I put a row right here, or right about here, and same amount over on the other side of the garlic over there, we'll have two rows of garlic over here. We'll plant those. These should be ready about the end of June. The onion, it says that about 100 days, about 100 days. So, you know, that would make it, let's see, May, June, July, that's 90 days. So sometime in August, we'll have onions. Now, so the garlic at the end of June, and let's see, let's just say the first of April. April, May, June, July, August. About August, September, roughly, these will be ready. So, like I say, you can see the corn right here. This is sweet corn. And the only reason I plant corn this year is because there's 300 acres of farmland around us. And the challenge I have is it's Monsanto crops that they plant. You know, and they know how I am about that. That's why I got this plastic, for one reason at least. It helps a little bit. Not much, but a little bit. And I get pissed when they're spraying or anything. They usually come by here real slow if they're spraying, go around and then go back. You know, but right up around the last edge and all that, they've been very nice and very polite, I guess you'd say, and not spray so fast. And that's a marigold that we had bought at a chain store with a K. And there were six. They all died except that one. My wife transplanted that one there. And like I said, plus we have seeds of marigolds to go all the way around the garden. See, marigolds are supposed to be a good deterrent to mosquitoes. And if you look on earlier videos, I hope I showed you some of the other municipal flowers I put out here, mainly in the wind, what I call my wind fence, which are going to be, it's going to be a natural wind fence with the sunflowers. Okay, that's like I explained last year. See, now all that stuff last year, there were sunflowers and torch sunflowers. They were all right here, right along this garden right here, just about to where CJ's grave is, maybe a little bit further back. But they were right up on the garden. And I thought, well, no, I want it away because it'll help break the wind and such, and it'll attract the butterfly, honeybees, and even the hummingbirds for the torch sunflowers. So this is probably about 85, maybe more, torch sunflowers, and then the yellow sunflowers also. There's two different types of yellow sunflowers. Titan sunflowers, I got a little skimpy with that. It used to be 250 seeds, now they give you 25. I think it's 25. I could be wrong. It could be as low as 10, but it's not 250 like it was before. That's kind of really, really, that's like for some reason rubbing me the wrong way. I don't know why, but anyway, I got a lot of seeds anyway from these, so that's the only reason I'm not really calling and complaining about it. But you know, all I can say is, folks, try to grow your food. The better food you can get, the more healthy you'll be. The stuff you eat, especially from China Mart, and I don't give a shit what anybody says, China Mart is not healthy for you. Organic doesn't necessarily always mean really, really organic or real good. It could be. I'm not saying it's not, but why take the chance? I know what I'm growing. I know what I'm using. Protogrow is the next thing I'm getting. It's a quart for $29.95 from Heirloom Solutions, $29.95. You put 9 teaspoons into a gallon of water. It's fish emollients for fertilizer. And it really, it had done so much. And I'm stupid for not ordering it again sooner. But probably, maybe in a week or two, I might order it. And I mean, you can spray it on the leaves and everything else, because the plants are like humans. You know, they have pores and they take it in. So my biggest challenge, my worry, is the tomatoes in the first row and a half. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. There's 6 of them, and I know 5 of them probably aren't going to make it. But once this is all cleaned up, I get all this stuff like the cinder blocks and the bottles. I use them for water, for weight mainly on the plastic. That's going to be gone. And when it starts growing out and everything, it's going to look so big and so bountiful. Yeah, the only thing left is my pepper garden, which, you know, got quite a few of those. I'm not going to do a video on that right now because I said this is the last video I did on the garden itself. And that's what it looks like, okay? So I wish everybody had the space that we've been fortunate enough to have. You know, and I'll give it thanks, Mr. Thomas, Delmas Thomas. He said, you know, we could do whatever we want as long as we didn't tear up anything. I told him I wanted to do a garden. He said, that's fine. So this is the garden that I created about 2 years ago. And last year it was really bumpy, but we just made so many mistakes, but we're trying to correct all that this year. Last year we had probably about 85, 90% of everything come up. This year I expect 95 or better percent of everything coming up. And we'll have more and different stuff too, so more beans. Good luck, everybody. Your government's not going to take care of you no matter what they tell you. They're stealing your Social Security, so unless you prepare yourself, I'm trying to do the best I can. That's all I can say. I'm trying.